How do you view, with where you're at, 3-2-1 in the season, how do you view this upcoming stretch for what this is, for the challenge that awaits for the team?
I mean, it's a stretch, but for us, it's 1 week at a time. We know that we have obviously undefeated Rams team up this week, who a lot of people think is unbeatable. But, you know, as a player, your mindset is always set differently. Anyone who, you know, we feel is unbeatable, and obviously we know they're beatable at some degree. But they are tough, man. Tough team. Everything that they're advertised to be, they are. We haven't been who we, you know, who we say we were, and we're still working on that. But we feel confident about our chances going into LA, though, at the same time.
I know that you're focused on LA, but your reward for playing LA is then to go right around and go to Tom Brady. And so do you have to prepare any differently when there is a stretch like this than you would otherwise when it is just a tough game instead of a few?
No, like I said, it's week to week. You know, the stretch is there. It's nothing we can do about it. We got to face all those teams, but we only can do them at one time. You know, we can't, you know, look ahead to next week and talk about Tom Brady right now. You know, it's the Rams. You know, we understand what's coming up, but that starts off with the Rams. So that's who we focused on.
Hey, Tremont, what kind of value did you get out of the Russell Hall stuff, and how did that play with you?
It always, with me, we've done it once before, off-season, I think. It was pretty good because we get dialogue going on between, you know, not only, you know, coaches but players. You know, it was us and the receivers in there together, you know, with the DB coach and the receiver coach. And, you know, those guys are talking about the things that give them trouble. We're talking about the things that give us trouble and vice versa. And we go over film and look at some clippings of, you know, what we done well or what we might have didn't do so well. And I think it just helps everybody, you know, in general, to know that, okay, going forward, this is the way the defense is looking to attack us, or this is the way the offense is looking to attack us in some degree. So it's more of a self-scout thing, which I think really helps because we go against those guys every day at practice, and you never know what they're talking about in their meeting room. So you're able to bring them both together, and it helps out.
Do you think the bye came at a good time?
I don't know. I feel good, so a lot of other guys don't feel that way. But we're getting a lot of guys back, so yeah, I can say that. I think it's coming at the right time. You know, we got some guys coming off an injury who's going to help out our team, so it definitely helps out for sure.
This Rams offense, is it pick your poison and try to stop Gurley first, or?
I don't know. It's tough. I'm for one who I got the opportunity to play against them twice last year. And they're a pretty efficient offense. I'll just tell you that. They're a pretty efficient offense. They know what they want to do. They're good at it. And for some teams, you have to keep up. For us, we feel that, you know, we can play with them. And as I say, time will tell, though. You know, it's going to be a tough challenge. But, you know, greatness have never come, you know, from, you know, not tough tasks. So, you know, we're looking to take on these guys, and they're going to be tough, but, you know, we're coming to win.
We usually talk about players, obviously, but from a schematic standpoint, what's the toughest thing schematically that offense presents to a defense?
Just misdirection, eye discipline. And I think that's kind of been a theme of the year a little bit from a lot of offenses. Even starting off with the San Francisco offense. Guys, you know, like to get down and reduce splits, move guys all over the field. Personnel that you have to pay attention to. And your eye discipline have to be great because if not, you know, the game can get out of hand. So eye discipline with those guys. Obviously, they have a lot of great players across the board. So that alone will present problems.
Jermaine, what would it mean to this defense to get Kevin, Jair, and Josh as the top four cornerbacks, like on the field playing together, because of injuries that hasn't happened before a lot.
So that's tough, man. You know, the only good thing that you get out of it is getting other guys reps and who you have to count on. And throughout that process, you hope they grow you know, throughout that process in case, you know, they're leaned on to some degree throughout the season, which everybody will be. That's the unfortunate part of the NFL. Everybody will have to be counted on throughout the season, and that's why you want your best, your top 53 guys. That's why we kept 53 guys. We feel that they all can play at this level. But to get all four of those guys on the field together, it'll be awesome. You know, continuity is a big part of this this game. And if you can get all the guys on the field for, you know, a span of time, it always helps out, you know, your team play. But, you know, who knows? It's always in the air, man. Injuries are part of the game. It's tough.
When you talked to Shields this week, and are you surprised he was able to come back the way he did with his career?
I talked to Shields. I don't know if I'm going to talk to him this week, but that's my guy, man. I've been through a lot with Sam, and glad he was able to come back. I had no doubt that he can come back. It's just the fact, when you have those types of injuries, especially with the dialogue that's going on with concussions these days, do you want to continue to do it? And that's the question. Do you want to continue to do it? And after a certain amount of time off, you know, he came to that conclusion and he went and got help for it and realized that he wanted to continue to do it. And he went out to L.A. and he's doing good for that team. So I'm glad to see that.
You guys played together a long time. He ever consult you?
Yes, I talked.
Process of whether he should come back?
Yes, I talked to him quite a bit about it. You know, and it went different ways. All the conversations didn't go the same way all the time, you know. At one point, you know, I was on a bandwagon with him, be like, man, you need to call it quits. And on the other side, you know, after he didn't have some time off, his mind's cleared and he's back mentally ready to go. If that's where your heart is, then go for it. So I've been on both sides of those conversations. I've been with him on both sides of them. So, but I'm glad he's back and he's looking great. He's doing well.
So what is that balance like? Because you want him to be happy, obviously, and if he desires something, you want that for him personally, but also the, like you said, the concussion concerns and the danger that does present itself. How did you balance that from a consultation perspective?
Well, just like anything, if you go through the process of trying to do the work of making sure that everything's better, you know, you can live with it. And he did do that. You know, he went and you know, to specialists and different people to make sure that he was good, and came back mentally ready to go. You know, if somebody just said, I just want to go back out there, and they didn't go through all the protocol to see if they can come back or, you know, what's the danger, what's the risk to it. But he did all of that. He did all that, and, you know, he got good feedback from the doctors that he can keep going, and I was with him.